This is Joe from The Pond Guy, here today to talk about how to control algae in your pond.
Algae is surprisingly beneficial for any pond and lake and is a sign of a healthy water body. Algae even provides food and habitat for pond fish. However, excessive algae blooms can cause oxygen depletion, muck accumulation, and ruin the aesthetic appeal and health of your pond. The first step in controlling algae is to identify the type of algae you're dealing with. Some algae can easily be mistaken for pondweeds. An easy way to distinguish between the two is to remember that aquatic weeds have well-defined root systems that anchor themselves to the pond's bottom. Algae, on the other hand, do not and grow by fragmentation. Algae can appear in your pond any place that receives sunlight and has available nutrients from decaying organics such as leaves and grass clippings. There are three common types of algae present in most ponds and lakes: planktonic algae, filamentous algae, and Chara. Planktonic algae are floating microscopic plants that can cause pond water to turn a pea soup green color. Filamentous algae form long, visible chains, threads, or filaments. These threads start growing along the bottom of the pond in shallow water on rocks and other aquatic plants, forming mats that resemble wet wool. These mats then rise and float to the pond's surface. Some pond owners also refer to this type of algae as pond scum. Chara is a gray-green branched algae that has 6 to 16 leaf-like branchlets that grow in spirals around the stem. Bottom-growing Chara is often mistaken for other types of pondweeds, but can be identified from its musky, rotten egg smell and gritty texture due to calcium carbonate deposits on its surface. It can also be removed from the pond easily by hand. The final step is to apply treatment. Once you've identified the target as algae, select a treatment to manage the growth. There are two types of algaecides, liquid and granular. Floating mats of filamentous algae and suspended planktonic algae are best treated with liquid mixtures, such as algae defense and treatment booster, that are sprayed directly on the target algae. For bottom-growing Chara, use a granular algaecide and apply with a hand spreader. The granules will sink evenly over the algae bed for maximum contact. Follow these guidelines for successful algae treatment. Treat only actively growing algae. Algae must be present and actively growing in the pond. The treatment must make direct contact and absorb into the algae for it to be effective. Treat when weather is favorable. Though algae can grow in colder temperatures, pond water should be above 60 degrees Fahrenheit to be fully controlled by an algaecide treatment. Algae treatments are most effective on a day when rain is not expected in the immediate forecast. This allows for adequate absorption time. Treat only one-third of the pond at a time. During hot weather, as algae dies off, it can reduce the amount of available oxygen in the pond. Treat your pond in small sections, waiting 10 to 14 days in between treatments to ensure fish have an oxygen-rich environment. We always recommend to keep an aeration system or fountains running during treatment. Always read the product label for appropriate protective equipment and application rates. Pay special attention to cautions regarding water use restrictions for ponds used for irrigation, drinking, and swimming, or for ponds containing fish like koi and trout, as they are sensitive to copper-based treatments. When these fish are present, test the carbonate hardness levels and ensure they are above 50 parts per million prior to treatment. Follow up with the AirMax Ecosystem Pond Management Program. Algaecides are a great tool, but do not address the actual problem of excessive nutrients and organics. Following up with proactive pond management practices, such as aeration and natural water treatments, will reduce the accumulation of dead organic material and can help keep your water clear season after season. For more information, watch the AirMax Ecosystem Proactive Pond Management video. If you need help with weed identification, or would like more information on choosing the right product, visit our Weed ID Guide at thepondguy.com/weedidguide. You can also email photos of your pond and algae, and one of our pond experts will identify the target and help you choose the right product. Email photos to weedid@thepondguy.com.
For more expert tips, visit us online at thepondguy.com or give us a call at 866-POND-HELP.